part of the streaming anyway, because if somebody's checking if it's working and they see we're not in, they might think it's not working. Okay, so we are in streaming now. Okay, so Georgia, do you want to try, for example, the speaking part of the exam while waiting for somebody else to join us? Oh, okay, there's somebody coming. Sarah. Yes. So, Sarah.
Good evening. Hello.
Hi, good evening to you. Uh-oh. What's this? Uh-oh. Let's stop this. Okay, that's not what I wanted. Okay, so let's try a couple of exams, speaking part for the moment. So Georgia and Sarah, you're entering together. So good evening.
Good evening.
Good evening. Okay.
How are you?
Hi. No, but you are supposed to be at the exam.
Okay.
You're supposed to do the exam, the speaking part.
Okay. I don't have the exam.
You will not take it. It's okay.
No, no.
It doesn't matter. It's good practice anyway.
Yes.
Okay. So, good evening. Hello. Don't you reply?
Hello.
Have I lost you? I can't see you anymore. What's happening? Wait a second. I can't see you anymore. Can you see me?
Yes.
So what's wrong with my computer? What happened? Something. Oh, here you are back again. I did something wrong. I couldn't see anything, to be honest. Hi, so good evening, everyone. Good evening.
Hello.
Hi, Stefania, you are driving. Hi, Manuela.
Yes, hi, Maria Pia.
Hi.
Hi.
Hello, hello, hello. Okay, so we were, pretending to do the speaking part of the exam. Georgia and Sarah were doing it. So let's start all over again. So you're entering. Good evening.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Can I have your worksheets, please? Can I have your work? You're supposed to have a worksheet to handle to the examiner. So here you are. Dovreste avere dei fogli che dovete consegnare all'esaminatore. Quindi quando ve li chiede, here you are. Ecco lei.
Here you are.
Thank you. Now, my name is Maria Pia, and this is Miss So-and-so.
Nice to meet you.
What are your names?
My name is Georgia. I'm living in Verona.
Non si dice I'm living, perché è una cosa che fai abitualmente. It's a usual thing, so you use the simple present. I live in Verona.
I live in Verona. Verona, yes, is in the northeast of Italy.
Northeast.
Verona is famous for Romeo and Juliet and the arena.
And the arena. Okay, arena. Okay. What about you?
I love, I have two children, Victoria 6 years ago, and
six years old.
Okay, and Virginia one year older.
one and a half year old. Yeah.
I love my job. I'm teaching.
I'm a teacher.
Mamma, mi chiudi la porta.
I'm a teacher.
I love my job. And I love reading. I love running. And I love walking in the mountain.
Okay, perfect. But if they stop you, because they will grant you a few seconds to reply, so they might stop you, don't worry, it's okay. E se vi bloccano, non vi preoccupate, perché loro hanno i tempi proprio conteggiati, quindi se voi parlate più a lungo di quanto loro vogliono, ti dicono ok, non c'è problema, fermatevi là. Sara, what's your name?
My name is Sara. I live in Guastalla, Reggio Emilia. I'm 46 here.
46 andava benissimo.
Ah, okay. I'm a teacher of 36 children.
I'm a teacher in a kindergarten.
In a kindergarten.
Children from 3 to 6.
Mm-hmm. Okay. I love reading, walking, and cooking.
Okay, where do you live, Sara?
I live in Guastalla.
Mm-hmm.
In Reggio Emilia. Reggio Emilia is in the north of Italy, and is a small town, and I live here with my husband and my daughters, Anna and Matilde.
Okay, perfect. All right. Now, how do you go to school? I mean, you are a teacher in Georgia. How do you go to school?
I go to school in a car.
By car.
Because my school is, but my school is near.
Allora, even if yeah, anche se even if vuol dire anche se
my school is near at my home,
near my home house. Yes, even if my school is near my house, but so why do you go to by car? But
because I have two children, and I must to
bring them
to school. And
yes, but I have two children and I must bring them to school. Okay. So, I go to school, I go to work by car, even if my school is near my house, but I have two children and I must bring them to school too. Okay. What about you, Sarah? How do you go to work?
I go to my car.
By car.
Because my school is not near. Is not near to my home. My school is distant 20 kilometers of my to my home, I go to my car.
You go by car.
By car.
Yes, it's not near my house or my home, not near to, near okay. My house, okay? Non okay. Si mette tu. Mm-hmm. Okay, perfect. Now, I want you to tell me, I'm going to show you, okay. Ah no, prima sono un po' di domande, giusto. What did you do last evening? Yesterday evening? Or last night? Georgia.
Last night I watched TV because my children is in dad
DAD.
DAD, yes. Okay. And it's not possible to go out to house.
Ah, but are they positive? Did they prove that?
No, no, but in isolamento. Non so come si dica.
You still need to stay inside.
Yes.
You will spend Christmas inside.
No, but the quarantine is finished, maybe.
Christmas. Okay, how are you spending Christmas Day? How are you spending Christmas Day?
We go to eat with my mother, my father, and my parents.
Okay, we are going. If it's something you have already to visit my parents. If it's something you have already planned, se è qualcosa che avete già programmato, si usa il present continuous.
Okay.
We are going. We're going to visit my parents.
Okay.
We are going to ski. We are meeting friends. Okay?
Okay.
È qualcosa che già avete programmato. Se invece, I don't know, maybe we'll go to visit my parents. Non so, forse, ma andremo forse a trovare. È una cosa che non avete ancora programmata, allora si usa will e shall.
Okay.
So you're going to visit your parents. Okay, what about you, Sarah? What did you do yesterday?
Yesterday in the evening, I prepare I cook. I have cooked with my family because today I go to work, to school, fino alle 4.
Till
4 in p.m. And I relax. I'm relaxed. Watching a film, a Christmas film.
Okay, a relaxed watching a Christmas movie film.
Okay.
Yes, even if you say today, if it's something, if it's an action which is finished, you still use the past tense.
Okay.
So today I went to school till 4 p.m. Oggi sono andata a scuola, anche se oggi però è un'azione finita. Non ha nessun riferimento col presente e quindi si usa comunque il passato. Okay? Okay. I went to school till 4 p.m., but it's 5 p.m. now, so past. Nothing to do with. On the contrary, if you say, oh, I'm so tired, I have been to school till 4 o'clock today. In quel caso, sì, I have been or I have gone to school. Perché? Perché questo è il motivo per cui adesso sono stanca. C'è un collegamento col presente, capito? Allora, okay. Se c'è un collegamento col presente, si usa il verbo avere più past participle. Participle. I have been to school, I have gone to school. Ma se non c'è questo collegamento, solo per il fatto che sia successo oggi e non 50 anni fa, non ha importanza. È un'azione finita, si usa il passato, ok? So, today I went to school till 4 o'clock. Però, oh, I'm so tired. I've been to school till 4 o'clock today. Ok? E questo vuol, il significato è, ed è per quello che adesso sono così stanca, capito? C'è questo collegamento. Oh, ho sbagliato a scrivere participle. Participle. Past participle. Ah! Oh. Ok. Right. Ok. Ok, now I'd like you to talk on your own for about 1 minute. So I'm going to give each of you a photograph and I'd like you to talk about it. Okay? You ready?
Okay.
Now, Georgia, this is your picture.
Mm-hmm. In the picture, there are four people, two men and two women, and a little dog. These people are two couples,
coppie quando sono proprio accoppiati, diciamo, tipo, che ne so io, marito e moglie, due fidanzati, queste cose qui, two couples. Se invece vuoi dire un paio, tipo un paio, che ne so, di non lo so, un paio di calzini, allora diventa a pair. Ok, no, però couple. In questo caso there are two couples.
Couples. There are young people.
They are young.
There are young. This picture is these people are in mountain.
In the mountain.
In the mountain, and they walk.
They are not working at the moment, but they are probably walking in the mountains.
Mm-hmm. And they walk. It's a sunny day.
Yes. When you describe a picture, you use the present continuous. So they are walking. They are smiling. They are looking at the camera.
Okay.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. And the dog is looking at them. And it's a sunny day.
Sunny day.
What period of the year, in your opinion?
Autumn.
It's probably autumn.
Autumn or spring.
Why? Or springtime. Mm-hmm. Why?
Because the trees are green,
are bare, sono senza foglie. No, okay, these are evergreen trees. Questi sono sempre verdi e vabbè. But the other
dire che i cappotti non sono molto pesanti.
Okay, they're wearing raincoats, but not heavy raincoats. Yeah, okay. Yeah. So they're wearing raincoats. Stanno indossando giacche a vento, but not very heavy raincoats. Ma non giacca a vento molto pesante. Beh, Dio, veramente, this is quite heavy and this is quite heavy too. But anyway, yes. Mm-hmm. Right. Okay. So don't stop while talking. Talk as much as possible. Whatever comes to your mind. Okay. So... When you describe a picture, first the people, second, if there's somebody else, in this case a dog, third, what's around them, in this case the mountains, and then hypotheses, you know, whatever comes. I think it's probably, I don't know, springtime or fall, because blah, blah, blah. The period of the year, and if possible, the time of the day.
And it's, this picture is recent.
Yes, quite recent.
Because the people have the mask.
Are wearing face masks.
Face mask.
So yes, it's taken during the lockdown period, during the COVID, the pandemic period.
Yes.
Okay, right. Sarah, this is your picture. But these are, do you know who these are? This is my daughter, and this is her boyfriend, Nicola. My daughter is called Caroline, and this is Nicola, her boyfriend. And this is my niece, Jasmine, and her boyfriend, Gabriele. And this is my doggy dog. Because with the copyright, I cannot take, you know, pictures which are under copyright. And so I've taken a couple of mine. Okay, Sarah, tell us something about this picture.
Okay, there is in this picture, there is two women.
There are two
women. One is Maria Pia. And the other, forse,
is probably
a friend.
Yes, one of her friends.
They are happy because she laughs. They laughed, and she eat in a restaurant, probably in a restaurant. Or
allora, sempre con il present continuous. They're happy because we can see they're happy because they are laughing.
Okay.
Laughing, la GH in questo caso si pronuncia come se fosse una F e la U non si sente, laughing. They're laughing and they are eating, they are probably in a restaurant.
In a restaurant and probably is the
it's soggetto, it's
a Christmas period
time.
Because a time, because on the table there is a
Christmas star,
and aiuto.
And they're wearing heavy clothes. E stanno indossando abiti pesanti.
Yes.
Sweaters. A pullover or maybe a coat. So it's winter time. Yeah.
Okay.
It's probably a pre-pandemic Christmas.
Yes, probably.
Which means because at least 3 years ago.
Because they haven't mask.
Yes, they are not wearing
mask.
They aren't wearing, non stanno indossando le mascherine. They are not wearing masks. They aren't wearing masks to wear, portare, in questo caso, come indossare. Mm-hmm.
Cioè, significano la stessa cosa, indossare o portare?
Sì, to wear vuol dire portare nel senso di indossare, non portare come bring.
Ok.
indossare. Okay. Mm-hmm. They're not wearing masks.
Mm-hmm. Maria Pia's friends have a rose.
A bunch of roses.
Of roses.
A bunch of mazzo.
Okay. And she is very very happy because her laughter is
wide mouth.
Okay.
A wide mouth laugh. Un sorriso proprio a bocca aperta.
Esatto.
Wow. Esatto.
Okay. All right. Where do you think we are?
They are in a restaurant or?
Yes, but where is the restaurant in your opinion?
A restaurant of Verona.
Why?
Because there is a photo of the bridge.
Ponte Pietra Bridge in Verona.
Okay.
So the restaurant is probably in Verona. Right.
In Verona.
Okay. Fantastic. Good. Now, then what is there? Oh, yes. Now you're going to talk together for a couple of minutes. I'm going to describe a situation to you. A couple of parents would like their seven-year-old daughter to do some sport. Which sport do you think would be best suited to a seven-year-old child? So which is the best sport for a seven-year-old child? Football, baseball, basketball, table tennis, karate, yoga, skating, jogging, tennis, things, swimming. Okay, start talking together.
I think that the best sport for a 10 years old child is are swimming and first swimming. Second ski. Swimming because it's a complete sport.
because you train the up and down of the body. All parts of your body. Of your body. Yes, but you are supposed to talk together. So Giorgia, coinvolgi anche Sara.
And
so,
Sara, for you, which is the best part for a 10 years old child?
Child. Don't repeat the question. Simply say, what do you think, Sara? Do you agree?
I agree, but I think that there is important also sport of squadra.
Team sport.
The swimming is important because it's a complete sport, but also the another a sport of baseball, football, basketball.
Team sport. Quindi senza due davanti. Okay. You're right, swimming is important because it's a complete sport. But I think that team sports are also very important, like football, baseball, basketball, because they help to socialize, or because it's important for the children to play together. Okay, so
yes.
Talk with Georgia, parla con Georgia, non dire solo quello che pensi, dici a lei quello che pensi, quindi sì, hai ragione, però c'è anche da considerare, cioè parli con lei, capito? Mm-hmm. Ok.
Okay. Yeah.
And Georgia, yes.
Yes, I agree, because all sports are important. But for me, it's more important the sports, the outdoor sports for the children, because, for example, my my child work and study every day in a school or in the house. And for me, it's important that she
practices
outdoor sports. And ski, for example, is a sport, it's a outdoor sport in the mountain, and the air is clear. It's more
where
clear
the air. Ski. Air is clear. Ok, va bene Georgia, ma devi sempre parlare con Sara. Quindi, yes, I can see your point, it's right. But I think that being outside is also very important. Outdoor sports is also very important because children tend, don't say your children, children tend to stay inside a lot of time. So it's important for them to go out. What do you think, Sara?
I agree with Georgia. I think that this period of pandemic, child aiutami Maria Pia.
E non so come dire.
No, adesso te lo dico. È più tendono a stare in casa, sono più pigri.
Ah, are getting lazy? Are getting lazy. And tend to stay inside. To stay inside.
Mm-hmm. So I agree with you, Georgia. And if it's important, that it's important, a sport of out.
Yeah, outside. An outdoor sport. Outdoor sport. It's important to go outside and play or do an outdoor sport. Okay, yes, children oppure a child. Okay, in this period of pandemic, children are getting lazy and tend to stay inside. So it's important to go outside or do an outdoor sport. Oppure a child tends, a questo punto con la S, tends to stay inside, gets lazy, and so it's important for him or her, e quindi in questo caso può ritornare them, perché non, a child is impersonal, can be a he or a her. A he or a she, quindi can be him or her, and not knowing what to use, you can use they, them. Ok, quindi finché usate child è impersonale, va bene, singolare, però a quel punto a volte capita di dover dire lui o lei. Allora, siccome in inglese lui vuol dire maschio e lei vuol dire femmina, e non è come in italiano che si dà per scontato che il maschio si intenda in generale, allora si passa a they. Ok? Quando okay, non sapete se è maschio o femmina, anche se è singolare, si usa comunque they. Quindi, a child is getting lazy, or gets lazy and tends to stay inside, so it's important for them. It's important they go outside. It's important for them to go outside. Si passa al plurale. Okay, Good. So finally, you've got 30 seconds to agree on a sport. Avete 30 secondi per mettervi d'accordo su uno sport.
I think that swim or football.
Only one sport.
Yes, only one, sorry, only one.
But Sara, for me, for the children, swimming is the best sport because it's a complete sport, and the children loves water.
Okay.
What do you think?
I think that it's right that children love swim in the water. And so I agree with you.
Okay, perfect. Fantastic. Okay. Do you like doing or playing any sport, Georgia?
Yes, I love jogging because I love yoga.
You love yoga?
Yeah, jogging.
Jogging. Okay,
because I love outdoor sports. And for me, it's the best sport.
Okay, jogging. What about you, Sara?
Also, I love jogging and walking, but also Pilates because for me it is necessary to stirarmi.
To stretch your muscles.
Important to stretch my muscles.
Sì, la C fate finta che non ci sia, muscles, come se
muscles.
La C non ci fosse. Your muscles.
Okay, yeah.
Okay. All right, this is the end of the test. Thank you very much indeed. Goodbye.
Thank you.
Va bene. Okay, now is everybody in? All of you who wanted to join, I suppose they're here now. So I wanted to give you, just a second, the link to sign the presence before I forget, because I tend to forget these kind of things. So the 22nd of December. 22nd of December. Oh, here it is. Right. Okay. B1. Fantastic. This is the link. I'll put it on the chat. Please click on the link and sign your presence. You can do it later, Stefania, don't worry. Do it when you're at home. Don't make a car crash. Don't worry. Click on the link, fill in the form and post it. But you can do it later, Sarah. Stefania, don't worry. Okay, so where were we? Oh, okay, Manuela, don't worry. Where were we? Oh, yes. So this is the speaking part of the test. Did you have a look at the material I sent you in the file? Did anybody look at the book and the listenings and all the things I posted to you in the file? No one. Oh, okay. You can do that during your Christmas holidays. Nadia? No. Okay. Sorry. I thought you were saying something. Okay, so in any case, the reading part, reading and writing part, parts. Wait, just a second, I'm going to close the door. Okay, here we are. My sister came to visit us. Fantastic, I'm so happy. I'm going to show you how, so this is speaking part. Let's have a look at the reading part, for example. Okay, in the reading part, there are again four parts, so four sections. Okay, no, three sections, I think. And this is a section one, part one. Here, there will be five questions. Oh, sorry, am I sharing the screen? Can you see my screen?
No.
Oh, why didn't you tell me? Okay.
Okay.
So there are the first five questions will be a multiple choice. You have to look to read the text, can be a sign or a message or a letter or a WhatsApp message. Anyway, you read the text and you have to choose the answer A, B, or C. So, for example, have a look at this. This is a sign, an advertisement.
It's a palace. There is a minimum change in between.
Answer A, B, or C. Do you want to write this on the chat? Please write your reply in the chat. No answer? I can't see the chat.
Wait, this is minimum change of
So A, B, or C, in your opinion? Come on, try.
You bring it to.
Okay, A. Yes. What I wanted to tell you is that you must be very, very careful because all or more than one of the answers will have the words in the reading. So don't be fooled by the words. For example, if there's a 4 pounds or if there is a this time, don't, you know, think that's the answer because there's, you know, a corresponding word. You really must to look at the entire reading and understand its meaning. So, Pizza Palace, there's a minimum charge of £4 between 12:30 and 2 p.m. Everybody has to pay at least £4 between 12:30 and 2 p.m. A pizza costs £4. No pizzas are served between 12:30 and 2 p.m. Okay? So in this case, A, question, answer A was the correct answer. Then, number two.
Passenger must hold a valid ticket. Any passenger without a ticket will be required to pay me. Q. 10.
C. Do you agree with C? Right. As a matter of fact, passengers must hold a valid ticket. Any passenger without a valid ticket will be required to pay an immediate fine of £10. So if you travel without a ticket, you may have to pay £10 later.
No problem.
The price of a ticket is £10. If you don't have a ticket, you will have to pay £10 on the spot. So it's C. Okay? Any question, feel free to ask. Sono domande, fatele pure. Quindi vedete, sono molto sottili le differenze. Dovete molto stare attenti a ogni parola, ok? Perché per esempio uno poteva essere imbrogliato dal fatto che la A dice se si viaggia senza biglietto devi pagare una multa di £10. Però c'è scritto later, più tardi, e invece qui c'era an immediate fine of £10. E quindi era giusta la C, on the spot. Ok, message. A, B or C? Yes, the message says, Maria, your sister phoned. She can't meet you tomorrow because she has some problems. She wants you to phone her. How should Maria react? Send her sister an email, write to her sister, or call her sister? Call her sister. Because she wants Maria to phone her, okay? So you also need to know the different ways of saying the same thing, to phone or to call someone. Okay, number four. So, any idea? Hi, I got to the hotel really late. Had a car trouble. Everything is okay now. I'll relax a bit today and then do some shopping tomorrow. See you on Sunday. Lots of love, Lenny. So Lenny has to go back tomorrow. Lenny had a difficult day, or Lenny is going on holiday on Sunday. Okay, who wants to read and translate it? Christina, do you want to read and translate it? We can't hear you. Okay.
For me, Lenny go back tomorrow.
Has to go back tomorrow. Do you want to read and translate the postcard? Vuoi leggere e tradurre la cartolina? Can you see it? Riesci a vederla? Vuoi che la faccia più grande?
Io ho preso un hotel e cado e ho una macchina.
Ok, let's read and translate it together. Because, okay, let's read, let's see if I can make it bigger, not too big though. Okay, let's see and let's read and translate it together. Hi, ciao. I got to the hotel really late. Got è il passato di get. E get vuol dire 3000 cose. Ma c'è il trucco. Got to, quindi sono arrivata. Ho arrivato all'hotel veramente tardi. Had car trouble. Ho avuto dei problemi con la macchina.
In hotel.
Esatto, sono arrivato in hotel veramente tardi. Ho avuto dei problemi con la macchina. Everything is okay now.
Okay.
Ora va tutto bene.
Tutto è ok ora.
Ora. I relax a bit today.
Oggi mi rilasserò. E farò dello shopping domani.
Bene, do some shopping. Vedremo, poi farò dello shopping domani. Ci vediamo domenica.
No, ci vedremo domenica.
Con affetto, Lenny. E quindi okay. La risposta giusta?
Con affetto, Lenny.
Ok, number one, Lenny has to go back tomorrow. Lenny deve rientrare domani. No. Lenny had a difficult day. Beh, anche sì, ha avuto dei problemi con la macchina, è arrivato tardissimo in albergo. Lenny is going
Lenny
on holiday.
Had a difficult day, allora.
Esatto. Lenny is going on holiday on Sunday, ma non dice che va in vacanza, dice solo ci vediamo domenica. Magari anche al lavoro, no. Per quello che ne sappiamo noi. Ok, quindi la giusta era la B. Lenny had a difficult day. Ok? Now, can I tell you something about the word get? Get means a number of things. Oh, I'm writing too much. Ok, get means a number of things. But there's a trick, c'è un trucco, un barbatrucco. When it's followed by an adjective, it means diventare. Okay? So I'm getting lazy. Sto diventando pigra. I'm getting fat. Sto ingrassando, sto diventando grassa. Ok? It's getting dark. Si sta facendo buio, sta diventando buio. Ok? Quindi quando è seguito dall'aggettivo vuol dire diventare, become fondamentalmente. Ok? Quando è seguito da una preposizione bisogna guardare la preposizione. Preposition. Ho sbagliato a scrivere preposition. Preposition. Bisogna guardare la preposizione. Allora, to vuol dire a. Quindi get to vuol dire arrivare a. Ok? So Lenny got to the hotel very late. Lenny è arrivata all'albergo molto tardi. Ok? Up vuol dire su, quindi get up, alzarsi. Down vuol dire giù, quindi get down, scendi, vieni giù, Get down, okay? On vuol dire continuare, quindi get on, continua. Get on, continua.
Grazie.
Off vuol dire giù nel senso di scendere. Per esempio, off a bus, off a train. Quindi get off, scendi, scendi dal treno, scendi dall'autobus, scendi dalla macchina, ok? Off. On invece vuol dire salire, quindi get on, sali su, get on the bus, get on a car, ok? Away vuol dire via, quindi get away, andar via. Back vuol dire indietro, quindi get back, tornare, tornare indietro.
Ma non è simile a get down? Get off non è simile a get down?
Get up vuol dire alzarsi, get down vuol dire scendere. Down e giù. Ok, get up vuol dire alzati. Get down vuol dire scendi. Per esempio, if my child is on the table, what are you doing on the table? Get down, scendi giù dal tavolo. Cosa fai sul tavolo? Scendi giù, ok? Ma se è per terra...
Sì, però get off non è molto simile.
Come, scusa? I couldn't hear you. Non ti ho sentito, sai. Vabbè, niente. Se invece è per terra, what are you doing on the floor? Get up. Cosa fai per terra? Vieni, alzati, ok? Off invece e on sarebbe con gradino. Diciamo che è col gradino, ok? Quindi get on vuol dire fai il passo, il gradino per salire su qualcosa. Get on a bus, get on a car, get on a plane, get on... ok? E off è scendere col gradino, diciamo, ok? Get off the bus, get off the train, get off the plane. Mettiamola così, se ciò non c'è il gradino. No, il senso è salire dentro qualcosa o scendere da qualcosa. Ok, away, back, che altre preposizioni ci sono? Comunque bisogna guardare la preposizione. Get più la preposizione fa diventare, è un modo per verbalizzare, per far diventare un verbo la preposizione. Ok? Per far diventare verbo la preposizione si aggiunge get. Up e su. Get up, alzati. Down e giù. Get down, scendi. Away e via. Get away, vai via. Ok? E così via. Get però da solo, se non ha né preposizione né un aggettivo dopo, get da solo vuol dire entrare in possesso di, avere. Avere, entrare in possesso di. Ho sbagliato a scrivere. Avere. Per esempio, I got 2 tickets for the cinema tonight. I got 2 tickets. For the cinema, ho preso, può essere ho comprato, può essere li ho ricevuti, può essere me li hanno regalati, comunque resta il fatto che ce li ho. Ho 2 biglietti per andare al cinema stasera. I got 2 tickets for the cinema tonight. Quindi, tant'è vero che il participio passato got è un rafforzativo del verbo avere. I have got, ok? Perché vuol dire avere, entrare in possesso di, avere, ok? E quindi è usato anche come rafforzativo del verbo avere.
Maria Pia, sorry, you are writing everything about get,
I am writing everything in the chat. If you want to, I will send you everything by email.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, I will send you all this by email.
Thank you, Maria Pia.
No problems, Stefania. No problems at all. You are very welcome. And thanks for being with us while driving. Poor Stefania. Where are you going, Stefania?
Around Verona. I need... I traveling with my daughter.
You're taking your daughter somewhere.
Yes.
Okay, don't worry. I can perfectly understand. Yes, I will send you everything.
Okay.
Thank you. This is for get, because it's a verb which you will often find, perché è un verbo che troverete molto spesso, ok? Questo è lo schema del get. Get da solo vuol dire avere. Get con un aggettivo vuol dire diventare, quindi get thin, diventare magro, dimagrire, get fat, diventare grasso, ingrassare, get happy, diventare allegro, quindi... rallegrarsi, e così via, insomma, prende il significato dell'aggettivo. Get più preposizione prende il significato della preposizione. Serve per far diventare un verbo la preposizione. Ok? Bene, detto ciò, torniamo al nostro esercizio. So, Lenny had a difficult day. Ok. Number 4 or whatever it was, 5, I don't know. A, B, or C? A, B, or C? Ok. No guess? Aren't you trying to guess? Nessuno che prova a indovinare? B, qualcuno dice. Ok, let's read it together. Hi, the new printer you repaired is not working very well. The paper keeps getting blocked. I don't know whether to buy a new one or wait for you to sort it out. I really need to print some stuff urgently. Please let me know when you will be able to come. Regards. So, what does Miriam want Nabil to do? Buy her a new printer? Tell her when he will come, repair her old printer. Okay, let's read and translate. Does anybody want to read and translate it? Nadia, do you want to try? No, don't you want to try? Okay, who wants to try? Somebody else? Andrea, do you want to try? iPad, who is iPad? iPad, who are you?
Oh, hi, Mariangela.
Mariangela, do you want to try?
Yes.
Mariangela. Okay. Mariangela, oh. Yes.
Hi. The new printer you repaired is not working very well. La nuova stampante che hai riparato non sta lavorando molto bene.
Non funziona. Work
funziona.
Vuol dire lavorare, ma anche funzionare.
Mm-hmm. Ok. The paper keeps getting blocked. La carta si blocca.
Continua a rimanere bloccata. Keep vuol dire continuare. Mantenere. La carta continua a rimanere bloccata.
A bloccarsi. I don't know whether to buy a new one or wait for you to sort it out. ticket. Io non so se comprarne una nuova o aspettare, non so cosa vuol dire the sort, it out.
Che tu risolvi.
Mi verrebbe da dire se muore definitivamente. I really need to print some stuff urgently. Io ho veramente bisogno di stampare dei documenti urgentemente. Please let me know when you will be able to come. Regards. Per favore, fammi sapere quando sarai disponibile a venire. Saluti.
Ok, quindi A, B or C?
B.
B. Tell her when he will come. Ok, Miriam wants Nabil to tell her when he will come. Ok? Right. Ok, this was the last one. So this is the first part of the of the reading part of the exam. Let's see the second part. The second part consists in, again, 5 questions, 6 to 10. You have, for example, in this case, 5 people, and usually 7 or more possibilities, in this case of restaurants. These people wanted to go out for dinner. Decide which restaurant would be the most suitable for the people below. Ok, quindi dovete leggere le descrizioni delle persone e in questo caso decidere quale ristorante andrebbe meglio per loro. Può essere quale vacanza, può essere quale animale, può essere a seconda degli esercizi. Ok, qui però ci vuole un po' di tempo a farlo. Mi sa che se lo facciamo insieme perdiamo un sacco di tempo, però per darvi un'idea di come, in cosa consiste la parte 2 dell'esame, magari facciamo il primo, dai. Annie and Joe have been married for 2 years and had their honeymoon on the Indian subcontinent. They wanted to celebrate their anniversary and are looking for something romantic. Being able to dance would be a real bonus. Quindi, cosa sappiamo? Che vogliono festeggiare il loro anniversario, il secondo anno di matrimonio. Sono andati in luna di miele in India, nel subcontinente indiano, e cercano qualcosa di romantico. Se si potesse anche danzare, sarebbe meglio. Ok? Quindi andiamo a vedere i ristoranti. Pizza's Pizzas. We have 35 different kinds of pizza toppings. And our special kids playground is why everyone comes here for fun. Why not come along and join in? Do you think it's appropriate?
No.
No. Luigi's. We have the best Italian food in the area, with the live music and dancing on Fridays and Saturdays. Come and enjoy a piece of Tuscan magic with candlelit charm. Our prices are very reasonable and there's no need to book in advance. Do you think it's appropriate?
No.
Not really. You can dance, but the roast, delicious British, The Lost is dedicated to the romance of classical British cooking and uses the finest seasonal herbs and spices. Our dishes, wines, and cocktails are constantly evolving, and wherever you sit, you will enjoy magnificent views. Is it appropriate?
No.
Not really. They talk about romance. It's a romantic place, but no. Let's see if there's something best. Vediamo se c'è qualcosa che va meglio. Something better. Coriander. We specialize in the best dishes from the Indian subcontinent with all the favorites. Visit us to sample our chef's signature dish, his chicken vindaloo masala, but be careful, it may be too hot for you. Discounts available for groups. What do you think about this one?
No.
No.
Not very romantic, is it?
Not romantic.
Hutong. The original hutong in Hong Kong is Gleedsley, high-end Chinese restaurant with magnificent views. And this branch of hutong is no different, with the same Sichuan and Northern Chinese menu. Dance videos playing on the walls give a very modern atmosphere. Shall we go on, see if what else we have? Paloma, we have the best croissant, cakes, coffee, and natural juices in the area. If you haven't been, Don Dennis, get together with your friends and enjoy the atmosphere of our serve-yourself seafood buffet. The roasted bean. We make coffee the way it should be made and with the best beans from all over the world. It's not surprising that we are considered the Mecca for true coffee lovers.
Hutong.
Either hutong or
the roast.
Coriander. Best dishes from the Indian subcontinent.
But there isn't a romance.
There isn't?
Romance. Romantic.
It's not romantic. It's not particularly romantic. The roast is deliciously British. But it's dedicated to the romance of classical British cooking. Quindi è dedicato al romanticismo della cucina britannica. Non è detto che sia proprio un posto romantico per... Però è vero che wherever you sit you will have magnificent views. Dovunque vi sediate avete delle viste meravigliose. So, what do you think?
Hutong.
Hutong or coriander?
Hutong because there are dance videos playing.
But dance videos. That doesn't mean you can dance.
Yes.
Okay, let's see what was the correct answer. Vediamo qual era la risposta corretta. Dov'è che l'ho messa le risposte? Wait a second. There must be the answer. But you see, it's not easy. You really need to understand non ce li ho. Sometimes there is more than one possible answer. A volte c'è più di una possibile risposta, eh? A volte accettano sia una che l'altra, per esempio. E non c'è la risposta, devo trovare la caspita. Ok, vi farò sapere la risposta. Then, so this was part two. Part three, there's a reading, quite a long text, see? And then there are the questions. Can be true or false or multiple choice A, B, C, D. Again, it's there's no point in reading everything, but this is the kind of exercise you will find during the exam. So you're supposed to read it and decide, in this case, if the sentences are true or false. In other cases, you have to decide, again, ice cream for dogs, you read it, and you have to decide if A, B, C, or D is the correct answer, okay? And then part four, what is there in part four? Part four is okay, there are sentences which you have to insert in a reading. There's a reading and some sentences are missing and they're put, you know, underneath. And you have to decide where to insert them. C'è un esercizio di lettura, mancano delle frasi che sono messe sotto e voi dovete decidere dove inserire queste frasi. But be careful because five sentences are missing, but you are given more than five possibilities. In this case, eight possibilities, which means that three of them will not have to be used. Che significa che tre di queste non dovranno essere usate. Ok? Solo cinque dovranno essere inserite. Dovete decidere quali e in quale posizione. Ok? Questa è la parte, è la quarta parte dell'esercizio di lettura. Quindi, be careful, don't choose straight away what looks immediately correct for you. Think carefully of all the possibilities and try to understand as much as possible both of the reading and of the questions. Okay. One good point is that the questions are in order. So question one refers to the first part of the reading. Question two comes after. Question three comes afterwards, and so on and so on. So if you are at question three and you cannot find the right place where the question, where there's the answer, just consider it's in between question two and question four. In that part, there must be the answer to your question three. Ok? La cosa bella è che sono in ordine queste domande relative al testo. Quindi, se voi non sapete dove si trova alla domanda numero tre, sappiate che è tra la risposta alla domanda numero due e quella al numero quattro. Lì in mezzo ci deve essere la risposta alla domanda numero 3. È in quella posizione lì, perché vanno per ordine. Ok? Questo è molto utile, perché se uno non sa, perlomeno ha idea di dove andare a dedurre quella risposta. Spesso, quasi sempre, le risposte sono di deduzione. Cioè, per esempio, uno ti dice qualcosa tipo it's a wonderful day today and I'm going shopping. Question number one. The sun is shining. Question number two. It's raining. Question number three. It's winter time. Question number four. I don't care about the weather. Okay, in this case, number one, because It's a wonderful day means the sun is shining. Okay, so they do not tell you or use the same words. If they use the same words, they are going to cheat you. non usano le stesse parole che ci sono sul testo. Quando usano le stesse parole è per imbrogliarvi. Quindi dovete veramente capire il significato del testo, ok? E le domande avranno lo stesso significato, ma espresso in maniera diversa. E questo ci porta a un altro passo. Dovete sapere almeno i più comuni phrasal verbs. Bico, do you know what a phrasal verb is? Sapete cos'è un phrasal verb? Ah, Adriana, ok. Merry Christmas to you too. Adriana dice che è molto stanca. She's very tired and she wishes to all of us a wonderful Christmas. Thank you, Adriana. The same to you. Okay, do you know what a phrasal verb is? It's a verb followed by a preposition, but because of the preposition, the verb changes its meaning. Il phrasal verb è un verbo seguito da una preposizione, però a causa di quella preposizione, poiché c'è quella preposizione, il significato del verbo cambia. Per esempio, run vuol dire correre. Ok? I'm running to school, sto correndo per andare a scuola. Però se io vi dico I'm running out of milk, I'm running out of milk, non vuol più dire correre fuori del latte. Run out vuol dire rimanere senza. Non ho quasi più latte, sto rimanendo senza latte, ok? E molti di questi phrasal verbs are used to change the sentence, keeping the same meaning. E molti di questi phrasal verbs sono usati per mantenere il significato della frase cambiando le parole. Quindi è molto importante per voi saperli, questi phrasal verbs. Let's have a look at a few of them. Diamo un'occhiata ad alcuni di essi. Ok, let's have a look at this. I had to decide. I wanted to make it a little bigger. Ok, can you read it? I had to decide what to study at university. But it wasn't easy for me. I had so many interests. Although I knew I was running out of time, I couldn't come up with a definite choice. To make matters worse, my parents were going through a divorce. So I never found the right time to bring this problem up and discuss it with them. I was looking forward to university life, but I feared it wouldn't live up to my expectations if I chose the wrong course. For a long time, I had dreamt of being a vet, but I finally realized I wouldn't be able to put up with the many years of study just to see animals suffering at the end. Then it dawned on me that if I was so interested in psychology, I might as well think about studying psychology at university. My parents were taken aback when I told them. They were afraid I would have problems getting by on a psychologist's hard life. In hindsight, I don't think it was a great decision. But everything turned out fine in the end. Okay, let's have a look. Let's read and translate. Who wants to read and translate? You're not Manuela. What's your name?
Io non ho capito niente.
Oh, bene. Ok, ma ti chiami proprio Manuela?
Sì.
Ah, ok, perfetto, perfetto. Perché? Allora, Manuela ci rinuncia. Chi vuole provare? Vediamo chi c'è che non ha ancora parlato. Daniela, do you want to try? Ilaria, do you want to try? Deborah, do you want to try?
Ci provo. Ilaria?
Ok, vai Ilaria.
Allora, io devo decidere...
Allora, can you please read, okay. Read it in English first and then translate it?
Ok. I had to decide what to study at the university, but it wasn't easy for me. I had so many interests.
Ok, quindi...
Devo decidere cosa...
Che ci devo?
Io non lo so.
To have to vuol dire dovere, però questo è had to decide, quindi dovevo.
Ah, dovevo, sì.
Dovevo decidere.
Io dovevo decidere cosa studiare all'università e questo è stato, non è stato facile per me, era
ma
molto
non
difficile.
Era facile per me.
Esatto. Io avevo molti...
così tanti interessi.
Interessi.
Ero interessata a così tante cose, ok? Bene.
Al fu, non so leggerlo.
Although, allora, la GH finale dimenticatevela, come se non ci fosse. La A seguita dalla L diventa quasi sempre O. Quindi, although
I know I was... I knew. I was running out of time. I couldn't come up with a definite choice.
Vuol dire benché sapessi che non avevo più tanto tempo, che stavo esaurendo il tempo disponibile, che non avevo più tanto tempo.
Io non riuscivo, capisco il senso, ma non so la traduzione letterale.
Okay. Non riuscivo a fare una scelta definitiva.
To make matter worse, my parents were going through a divorce. So I never found the right time to bring this problem up and discuss it with them.
Quindi to make matters worse, a peggiorare le cose, a fare le cose peggiori, to make matters worse, a peggiorare le cose.
I miei genitori sono andati incontro a un divorzio.
Sì, stavano passando attraverso un divorzio.
E non ho mai trovato
il momento giusto per sollevare questo problema
e discutere di questo con loro.
E discuterne con loro, esatto.
I was looking forward to university life, but I feared it wouldn't live up to my expectation if I choose the wrong course.
Quindi, I was looking forward to university life. Non vedevo l'ora di fare la vita da universitaria. But I feared, ma avevo paura, temevo, it wouldn't live up to my expectations, che non sarebbe stata all'altezza delle mie aspettative if I chose the wrong course.
Se avessi scelto
il corso sbagliato.
For a long time I had dreamed of being a
veterinario.
But I finally realized I wouldn't be able to put up with the many years of study just to see animals suffering at the end. Per lungo tempo il mio sogno era...
avevo sognato di fare il veterinario.
Ma a un momento alla fine ho realizzato che non volevo passare
no, attraverso tanto. Che non sarei stata in grado di affrontare i tanti anni di studio solo per vedere gli animali che soffrivano alla fine.
Ok. Then it dawned on me, that if I was so interested in psychology, I might as well think about study psychology at the university.
Sì, allora la P fate finta che non ci sia. Psychology. Okay. Then it dawned, la E della E di finale non si pronuncia. It dawned on me that if I was so interested in psychology, I might as well think about studying psychology at university. Mm-hmm.
Allora, non lo so.
Poi, it dawned on me, sarebbe mi si è illuminata la cosa, mi sono resa conto che...
Ero interessata.
Che se io ero così interessata alla psicologia, tanto valeva che pensasse di studiare psicologia all'università.
Ok?
Avrei potuto... a quel punto pensare di studiare psicologia all'università.
Okay. My parents were taken aback when I told them. They were afraid I would have problems getting up on a psychologist's hard life. I miei genitori mi
chiesero sorpresi.
Furono sorpresi quando dissi loro.
Quando gliel'ho detto, esatto.
They were afraid.
Avevano paura, temevano. Avrei avuto problemi.
A prendere...
Getting by on vuol dire a vivere con... a vivere... con la dura vita di uno psicologo, psychologist hard life.
In hindsight,
col segno di poi, guardando indietro,
I don't think it was a great decision, but everything turned out fine in the end. Mm-hmm. Tornando indietro, io non credo sia stata una grande idea. Mm-hmm. Ma tutto sommato turned out alla fine
si è risolto per il meglio.
Ok.
Quindi run out of vuol dire esaurire, rimanere senza qualcosa, quindi finish a supply of something. When run out of fuel, so we had to push the car in the end. Siamo rimasti senza carburante e quindi abbiamo dovuto spingere la macchina. Quindi rimanere senza, esaurire, ok? Finish a supply of something. Terminare la scorta di qualcosa. We ran out of fuel. Ran è il passato di run, of course. We ran out of fuel. Siamo rimasti senza carburante e quindi abbiamo dovuto spingere la macchina alla fin fine. Come up with vuol dire inventare, venire fuori con un'idea, ok? O menzionare qualcosa. A number of interesting points came up at today's meeting. Una serie di punti interessanti sono venuti fuori all'incontro di oggi, ok? To come up vuol dire venire fuori nel senso di venire fuori con un'idea. Go through vuol dire passare, attraversare, però qualcosa di brutto di solito. To experience something bad. She's going through a bad period. She's going through a divorce. She's going through, I don't know. Ok, qualcosa di brutto. Sta passando un brutto periodo. Sta passando divorzio, qualcosa di brutto, insomma. Bring up invece vuol dire sollevare un problema, un argomento. To mention a subject or start to talk about it. Bring it up at the meeting. Parlane all'incontro. Tira fuori questo punto all'incontro. Bring it up at the meeting. Look forward to vuol dire non veder l'ora di, attendere con impazienza qualcosa. Ok, I'm looking forward to meeting you at the weekend. Non vedo l'ora di incontrarti nel weekend. Ok, I'm looking forward to meeting you. Live up to vuol dire essere all'altezza di. Ok? He failed to live up to his parents' expectations. Non riusciva a essere all'altezza delle aspettative dei suoi genitori. He failed to live up to his parents' expectations. Put up with, sopportare. Face something unpleasant. She had to put up with many problems in her life. Ha dovuto ha dovuto affrontare molti problemi nella sua vita, ok? Put up with vuol dire affrontare qualcosa di brutto, di spiacevole. Take back vuol dire sorprendere, scioccare. To shock or surprise somebody very much. I must admit that I was taken aback when I heard we weren't receiving our bonuses this year. Devo ammettere che sono stata veramente scioccata, sorpresa, quando ho sentito che non avremmo ricevuto i nostri bonus quest'anno. Ok? Get by on vuol dire farcela con. Manage to live or do a particular thing using the money, the knowledge, the equipment that you have. How can she get by on such a small salary? Come fa a sopravvivere con un salario così basso? Ok, get by on something vuol dire farcela con qualcosa. Turn out vuol dire rivelarsi. To happen in a particular way, to develop or end in a particular way. Despite our worries, everything turned out well. Nonostante le nostre preoccupazioni, tutto alla fine è finito bene. Okay, so these are a few ideas. Now I realize that I made very difficult sentences. I should maybe have done it in the present tense, not in the past with the conditionals and so on. I didn't realize it at first. Adesso mi rendo conto che effettivamente le frasi erano molto difficili per voi. Avrei dovuto magari metterle al presente piuttosto che al passato con condizionali, eccetera, eccetera. Comunque, questo era un esempio di alcuni phrasal verbs, di alcuni verbi phrasal verbs che potrebbero venire fuori. Okay, for example, let's see, Deborah, do you still have milk left in your fridge?
Yes, I have.
You didn't run out of milk. You didn't run out, not yet. Okay. Mariangela, did you run out of patience with me? Hai esaurito la patienza con me?
Non ho sentito.
Did you run out of patience with me? Did you?
No.
Hai perso il... Ah no, perché è andato a scrivere su Nadia, maledizione? Perché sto scrivendo a Nadia? Io voglio scrivere a tutti. Ok.
No, I don't. Because you are a wonderful teacher for me.
Of course not. Of course I didn't. Of course not. No way. Ok. Quindi run out of patience. Ho sbagliato a scrivere of patience. Ok. Stefania, tell me something you ran out of. Dimmi qualcosa che hai esaurito.
Patient. Patient to stay in the traffic.
Yes, I ran out of patience.
In my fridge, I ran up my eggs.
You ran out of eggs. I ran out of eggs. Allora, run è il presente, ran. Scusate, allora, to run, ran, run. Ok, quindi run è il presente, ran è il passato.
Ok.
Quindi I ran out of eggs. Sono rimasta senza uova. Ho esaurito le uova, non ho più uova. Ok?
Ok.
Good.
Maria Pia?
Yes.
Can I say I ran out of energy?
Yes, I ran out of energy. I finished all my energy. I have no energy left. Yes. Sarah, did you run out of something?
I ran out my patience, because children in this day are very, very
demanding. Come si può dire in italiano? Impegnativi, che ti richiedono tanta energia.
Agitati.
Oh, they are very lively. Ok, they are very lively. Allora, sono okay. Molto vivaci, agitati. Esatto. They are really lively. Pensavo che lo vedessi dal tuo punto di vista. They are very demanding. They are very. No, they are very lively. Ok, lively. But this was the last day of school, wasn't it?
Yes.
Now we are on holiday. Ta-da!
Oh, no, tomorrow we have school.
You have school
for me
tomorrow.
Today.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, no. For some reason, I have no school tomorrow.
Lucky you.
I don't know. For some reason, I have no school tomorrow. I'm on holiday already. Ta-da!
Okay,
I'm with you, but this is holiday for me. This is not work. It's a pleasure. Okay, so one more day. Okay. Quindi run out of, or run out of vuol dire finire, rimanere senza. Okay? Poi cosa c'era? Put up with. Put up with, che vuol dire? Affrontare, sopportare qualcosa. How can you put up with him? Come fai a sopportarlo? How can you put up with him? How can you put up with him? Come fai a sopportarlo? Ok? Put up with vuol dire affrontare qualcosa, sopportare qualcosa. Mm-hmm. Poi cosa abbiamo visto? Non mi ricordo neanche più. Abbiamo visto... Forse dovrei chiudere un po' di robe. Ho talmente tante robe. Ok, oh, look forward to, look forward to. Deborah, tell me something you're looking forward to. Tell me something you're
Look forward to arrive tomorrow because for me is the last day of working.
Yes. Okay, I'm looking forward to tomorrow. Non vedo l'ora che arrivi domani. Oppure se vuoi usare il verbo arrive, tieni conto che il verbo va nella forma in ing, perché questo tu non è un tu dell'infinito, fa proprio parte del verbo. Quindi, I'm looking forward to getting to tomorrow. Ok, I'm looking forward to getting to tomorrow. Non vedo l'ora che arrivi domani. Ok, to arriving.
Because I'm very tired.
Yes, because I'm very tired of working. Yes. Ok, so Manuela, are you looking forward to something?
I look forward to born my nipote.
I'm looking forward to to seeing my are you the grandmother or the aunt?
Grandmother.
Oh, to my grandchild. Wow, fantastic. I'm looking forward to seeing my grandchild, to having my grandchild born. Mm-hmm. Non vedo l'ora di vedere mio nipotino, non vedo l'ora che mio nipotino nasca. When is he or she due? When is he or she due?
Is or she due vuol dire nasce?
Dovuto, nel senso quando dovrebbe nascere, letteralmente quando è dovuto, quindi quando è che dovrebbe nascere?
He or she
should be born
at 8 June.
In 8 days. Wow.
No.
In 8 days. No.
At 8 June.
On the 8th of January. Okay.
Junior.
Ah, June. Oh, that's why you still don't know if it's a he or a she. Ecco perché ancora non sai se è un lui o una lei. Esatto. Ah, June.
The last day of school.
On the last day of school. That's a wonderful present. Okay, best wishes, Manuela. I really wish you a wonderful grandchild. On the 8th of June, okay. Anybody else? Don't you want to tell me something you're looking forward to?
I'm looking to opening the Christmas present.
I'm looking forward to opening the Christmas presents. Yes. Me too. Me too. Anybody else? Si usa molto spesso con il present continuous. I'm looking forward to doing something. Perché non vedo l'ora di, è una cosa che sta avvenendo in questo momento, quindi I'm looking forward to doing something. Ok. Anybody else? Don't you want to make an example? Daniela, Ilaria, Andrea, Nadia. Ok. So, to look forward to vuol dire attendere con impazienza, non veder l'ora di far qualcosa. Spesso si scrive anche nelle lettere alla fine, I'm looking forward to hearing from you. Non vedo l'ora di avere tue notizie. I'm looking forward to your letter. I'm looking forward to meeting you. Non vedo l'ora di incontrarti, ok? I'm looking forward to doing something. Ok, poi cosa avevamo fatto? Vediamo. Vabbè, turn out anche è un verbo che si usa molto. Turn out vuol dire rivelarsi, alla fine venire fuori qualcosa di bello, ok? Oppure anche di brutto, ma comunque, come dire, rivelarsi alla fine una cosa. Per esempio, I didn't want to go to the party. I thought it was boring, but it turned out to be very funny. Ok, I didn't want to go to the party, non volevo andare alla festa. I thought it was boring, pensavo fosse noiosa. But it turned out, si è rivelata, to be very funny in the end.
Divertente.
Ok, ve lo scrivo. I didn't want to go to the party. I thought it was boring. But it turned out to be funny in the end. Ok? Non volevo andare a festa, pensavo fosse noiosa, ma invece si è rivelata divertente alla fine. It turned out to be funny in the end. Ok? I didn't feel like taking the exam. I thought it was too difficult for me. But no, it turned out to be very easy in the end. Okay, I didn't want to do the exam. Non volevo fare l'esame. I thought it was too difficult for me. Pensavo che fosse troppo difficile per me. But it turned out to be easy. Ma si è rivelato facile in the end, alla fine. Ok, to turn out vuol dire, sì, rivelarsi nel senso di, non so come dire in italiano, aiuto. Comunque, prendetelo così, imparatelo così, turn out. Then, I would like to tell you something that can be very, very useful to you. And it's a website. It's called, cancelliamo un po' di roba, va, che ho un sacco di robe qua. It's called Word Hippo. Word Hippo. And I use it a lot for synonyms. For example, if you don't know what turn out means, you can type it. No, fine, I didn't want turn out, fine. Turn out, only turn out. You type it and these are the possible synonyms. Arrive, appear, attend, or to have. Okay, it can have various meanings. It can mean arrive somewhere, or it can mean happen or end up in a particular way. So to become, to eventuate, to result, to prove, to develop, to evolve, to happen, to transpire, to come out, end up, finish up, okay? So these are all synonyms. And this is the general meaning, arrive somewhere, happen or end up in a particular way, prove, true or factual, make or produce, vabbè. Okay. You can also find the translations. Let's see, from English to Italian. Let's see, turn out. Rivelarsi. Sì, principalmente rivelarsi, poi ha un sacco di altre, vedete, molto piccole altre accezioni, però soprattutto vuol dire rivelarsi. Si è rivelato bello alla fine, è venuto, sì. Ok, quindi questo word hippo can be very, very useful to you. For example, let's say we want to say Merry Christmas, but we don't want to say Merry. So we can say cheerful Christmas, jolly Christmas, for example, glad, joyful, I don't know, happy Christmas, laughing Christmas, bright Christmas, fun loving Christmas, amusing, vivacious. Okay, these are all possible synonyms. In good spirits, entertaining, and so on, pleasant. Okay, so if you don't want to say Merry Christmas, you can say pleasant Christmas, joyful Christmas, glad Christmas, a happy Christmas. Okay, these are high-spirited Christmas, lively Christmas, and so on and so on. And this is something which can be very useful to you when you practice the writing part, because when you have to write a text, it often happens that you have to change the, you need to change the word. So if you practice with the word hippo, you can enlarge your vocabulary. Allora, Daniela non ha ancora capito cosa vuol dire turned out. Vuol dire rivelarsi. Vuol dire alla fine, per esempio, I didn't want to go to the party. Non volevo andare alla festa. I thought it was boring. Pensavo fosse noiosa. But it turned out to be funny in the end. Ma alla fine si è rivelata essere divertente. Ok? Turn out vuol dire, sì, rivelarsi fondamentalmente. È che rivelarsi in italiano non si usa tanto, invece turn out si usa tantissimo in inglese. Ok? No problems, Daniela, you're very welcome. Any question, I'm here for you. Certamente che non c'è problema. Per qualunque domanda sono qua apposta. Ok, so... Shall we wish ourselves a Merry Christmas? Have a Merry Christmas and a fantastic 2022. Manuela, can you give us your wishes for Christmas? I wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Okay. Mariangela, can you give us your wishes for Christmas?
Yes, I wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year and a long time of school. No DAD.
Oh, okay. Without a DAD. Okay. Sarah, do you want to give us your wishes? Merry Christmas and Happy New Year. To you all, a voi tutti. Mm-hmm. At all vuol dire affatto. Okay. Quindi to you all. Yes. Okay. Bye. Mm-hmm. Okay, Sarah, do you want to give us your wishes for Christmas?
I wish you a pleasure. Christmas. Relax, serenity, and love, because I think that we we must lock the
laugh. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Scusate. Laugh. Sì, stavo dicendo full of joy, a new year full of joy, health, salute.
Esatto.
And so on. Mm-hmm. Laugh, sì, laugh si dice laugh.
Ok.
Yes, thank you, thank you. Cristina, do you want to give us your wishes? We can't hear you.
I wish you a Merry Christmas and bright New Year.
And a bright New Year, yes. And a bright New Year, un luminoso anno nuovo. Thank you, Cristina. Giorgia, do you want to give us your wishes?
Yes, Merry Christmas all together. And I hope that in this period I can sleep
and relax.
And relax.
Yes, I wish you to be able to relax and sleep and, you know, yes.
Thank you very much.
Andrea, do you want to give us your wishes?
I wish to you all Merry Christmas and a brightness New Year.
And bright New Year. And bright, a bright New Year. Yes. New Thank year. You, Andrea. Deborah, Thank do you want you. To give us your wishes?
Yes, I wish you Merry Christmas and a New Year full of love, peace, serenity, and health.
Yes. Thanks a lot, Deborah. Thanks a lot. So who's missing? Ilaria, do you want to give us your wishes for Christmas?
Yes, I wish you Merry Christmas and a happy New Year.
No. Thank you, Ilaria. Thank you. You too. The same to you. Stefania, do you want to wish to give us your wishes?
Yes. A lot of Merry Christmas and a wish for a good year, and a lot of love and relaxing and a lot of good thing and happy things.
Thank you, Stefania. Thank you, everyone. Anybody else? Does anybody else want to say something? Qualcun altro vuol dire qualcosa? No, mi sa che ce l'avete tutto? Tutti detto qualcosa? Ok. So, Merry Christmas! Enjoy your holidays, relax, and really stay with your relatives. Have a wonderful Christmas holiday. Bye, everyone! Bye!
Bye!
Thank you. Bye. Thank you very much.
Bye!
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 Bye. Bye. Somebody wrote, thank you, super teacher.